Say go.
Say go.
Great. All right, my friends, we've had a wonderful time with the lecture, and I want to thank you all for your enthusiasm, and I hope that you get something of value for yourself. As a parting gift, I want to share with you a few of my favorite mysteries with playing cards. Rather than use my own deck, I want to borrow a deck and share with you something, okay? We've got a bicycle second poker deck here. All right, this looks like it's in pretty good condition. I think we can work with this. Oh, yes. Take out the jokers. I love card magic. There's something really simple and elegant about the prop, and yet a thousand stories to be told. One of the questions I get asked a lot is, what does it take to become really expert with the deck of cards? And it's really quite simple. It comes down to one concept: card control. Training the fingertips to do extraordinary things. I'll share with you a few things right now. Would you like to help me? Yes? When I turn my head, I'm going to release the cards very slowly. You tell me stop, all right? Where we go?
Stop.
Happy with that one? Can you see it? Everyone? And the nice thing, my head was turned while you were looking at your card. Now, the first concept. A layman actually said this to me, that it was possible to count the cards as they came off my fingertips. Think about it, it's quite obvious. And with sufficient practice, you could tell roughly where the card is, especially as they haven't been shuffled. And because the fingertip control is so fine, I should be able to locate the card with one finger. Just one finger. So look, there are no bent corners, no cards sticking out. For the first time, what was the name of your card?
Six of clubs.
Yeah. With one finger.
Wow.
Whoa, thank you. And that's a little example of how far we can go with a little bit of card control. Let's take it a stage further. Give me a number from 1 to 10.
Six.
The six? You've had a six, so you want to continue with the six? I don't mind. If you want six, we'll use the sixes, okay? All right, let's have a look. There should be two more in here. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, here they are. The diamond, all we now need is the six of clubs. Okay, this was shown to me by one of my very first teachers in magic, a magician named Seinfeld. He was a movie director, but he did good card tricks. And he told me that to become great with cards, you've got to develop control of every card in the deck. But you've got to start small with, say, any four cards, the nines, the sixes, it doesn't matter. So I'm going to do this very slowly for you, okay? I want you to watch this very closely, okay? Six of clubs, the spade, the heart, and the diamond. I hope that wasn't too fast for you. Not too fast for you either? Okay, watch closely. I'm going to take the sixes and isolate them into half of the deck, like this. I just want to note their positions. Okay, push them in. And I'm going to ask you, my friend, to give the cards a shuffle, but keep the cards in my view at all times.
Okay.
That's pretty good. Perfect, and then leave the cards down on the table. Now, I want to keep your half separate from mine. So I'll leave yours face down. Mine will stay face up. And now this is where the card control comes in. By shuffling the two halves together very slowly, I won't complete the shuffle, but I'll just allow them to pass straight through each other.
No way.
Your half of the deck has now become a little bit smaller. Because mine is just slightly larger.
Bro. Whoa. Whoa.
Thank you. Now, what would ultimate card control look like? You want to shuffle these for me? We've been working with one card, we then did it with four cards, the four sixes. Let's see if we can work with the entire deck. And the best way to illustrate this particular concept is to go through the cards and separate all the red cards from all the black cards so that we've got two separate halves of the deck, separated by color, blacks and reds. Can you all see that? Good? Do you remember during the lecture I showed you the different ways of shuffling? For a gambler, they have to learn to control cards no matter what style of shuffle is being used. Do you remember we discussed
the overhand shuffle?
Mm-hmm. Even with this style of shuffle, it's still possible to keep all 50 cards under complete control.
Yes.
Reds and blacks separated. Mm-hmm. Things get slightly more challenging when the cards are shuffled exactly as they are in the casino by the croupiers. Like this. Split the deck in half. Shuffle two halves together. But in the hands of a skilled mechanic, you can still maintain control over all 52 cards. I was working in a casino once, and I actually saw how the casino croupiers shuffle. They don't just work with one deck, they work with about seven decks.
Seven decks?
Inside a big box called the shoe.
Oh.
How do you shuffle a big number of cards? A little bit at a time. Small packets. And then you join all the packets together until the whole deck has been shuffled. And I'll do it with these cards right now. Let's see. 3, 6, 9, 12 plus 1 gives us 13. And we've got another 13 over here. 3, 6, 9, 12 plus 1 gives us 13. Do that again. 3, 6, 9, 12, 13, 13. So you can help me. Can you shuffle these red cards? Okay. Actually, I'm giving you the wrong packet. Shuffle these as well. Give these a shuffle, and I'll shuffle these. Perfect. Lovely. You happy with that? So with these cards shuffled, okay, we can complete. Give these another shuffle. Perhaps you'd like to shuffle these as well. So now that we shuffle the individual halves of the deck, we can return them to their thoroughly mixed up condition by shuffling these two halves together. And it's a perfect shuffle, like we discussed earlier, of blacks and reds. And another perfect shuffle over here of blacks and reds. So right now, there can be no doubt in your mind. Blacks and reds over here, blacks and reds over here. Could it be possible to have complete control over the cards since we've all shuffled them?
No.
Well, I think the answer to that question
no.
is a resounding yes. Complete control over all 52 cards. However, let's just do this. Can you push them together for me? Okay, really push them in. This simulates a real shuffle. Very good. Excellent. Keep shuffling. In fact, why don't we do it as we did as kids? Let's just play 52 card pickup. Go for it. That's it. This is called a scramble or a gambler's wash. All right, perfect. Right now, are you aware of the order or position of any card in this deck?
No.
I've just flashed the bottom card to you, but I want you to... Oh, we've got the ace of spades. Okay, and then there's the two of clubs. There's the queen of spades. So if I go through the entire deck now, you can see that all the reds and blacks are being shuffled together. Look at that. Absolutely perfect shuffle. I want to do one more shuffle, in fact a few more shuffle, because I want to show you how now it's possible to control cards, not just any card, but specific cards throughout the entire deck, using a system known as shuffle tracking. I'm going to turn one half of the deck face up, and just like I did earlier, shuffle the cards together face up and face down. But I want you to see this shuffle, because I'll do it very slowly. I want you to see the cards being mixed into each other and cut face up, face down. In fact, I'll show you the condition of every card in the deck with this topsy-turvy condition. And because of this condition of the deck right now, one more shuffle should do it. And you can see the cards being mixed together perfectly. And look at the condition of all the cards, face up, face down, throughout the entire deck. So the question is, how much control can you have over the cards while they're in this condition? Well, to end this performance tonight, I'd like to show you what I consider to be the ultimate in card control. Because I can tell you right now, dead center, where there is an ace of hearts. The second ace, I think it's the ace of diamonds, is slightly further down in the deck. There it is. When you consider this deck was shuffled face up and face down, we have an interesting situation here. And it doesn't matter which way you shuffle the cards, we'll always have a little bit of chaos in the deck. I'm now looking for one card, particularly the nine of clubs, my lucky card. Because we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And last but by no means least, the last ace is like trying to find a needle in a haystack. Watch this, my friends. This is a triumph of order over chaos. Wow. And would you like to see one more?
Yes!
Okay. This one is a visual masterpiece. And I want to take out the four kings. Because at the Magic Circle in London, I was given a challenge by some of my friends to come up with the perfect vanish of four cards. This is what I came up with. Okay. Four kings, four aces. And the idea was very simple, to isolate the four aces in between the four kings, like this. So you can see the situation. So with the cards in this condition, and I square them up nice and neatly, in fact, I'll leave this one till the very end. However, we still have the other three aces trapped in between the four kings. And yet, the magic happens.
Wow.
Instantly. Four kings. And that just leaves the ace of spades. I wanted you to see this vanish as it happens right under your very nose. You ready? Now look, I want to show you every card in the pack. No aces. Look here. No aces. No aces. Completely gone.
Wow.
And it's really interesting to bring all the aces back, one by one. Let's try this. 1, 2, 3. Gentlemen, just examine my hands, please.
No.
Nothing there? There we go. No secret pockets. A bit of friction. I hope this works.
Whoa.
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 Whoa. That's all four aces, my friend. Thank you very much. Pleasure to be with you always. Thanks, fellas.